National Unity Platform President Robert Kyagulanyi Ssentamu has held the much-anticipated mobilization meeting in Mukono. The meeting was originally supposed to be held in Nakabago. However, police barred the new procession through Mukono town and they were instead led through the outskirts of the district. The crowds were swayed to the newly designated Namataba grounds, which angered the party leaders and supporters. The Gulu City Woman Member of Parliament, who is also the former Leader of Opposition in Parliament, Betty Awol Ochan, has today signed the censorship document for ousting the four embattled parliamentary commissioners who allegedly shared 1.7 billion shillings as service awards. Awol condemned the manner in which the commissioners connived to share taxpayers' money and raised a question of legality of the transactions. Awol said that while she served as the Leader of Opposition, she did not receive such money as service award.
My commissioner, I never received anything. People kept on. My people of Gulu said, why don't they give you also something? I said, but until when it is discussed in Parliament. If it is not discussed in Parliament, it is not right. It is fraudulent and this is not acceptable.
Among others who signed on the censorship document is Yusuf Nsibambi, the Forum for Democratic Change Party whip. He said that as FDC, they have unanimously agreed to sign on the censorship document because they don't support corruption. South Africans are currently voting in what is considered to be the country's most important election in 30 years. The results are expected to be announced on Sunday, June 2nd. This election could significantly impact the nation's young democracy. At stake is the three-decade dominance of the African National Congress Party, which led South Africa out of apartheid's brutal white minority rule in 1994. It is now the target of a new generation of discontent in a country of 62 million people, half of whom are estimated to be living in poverty.
Everybody knows this country is deteriorating to such an extent, and we need a party to uplift us. We just need good things to happen. It's sad to see the way we go. We've had 30 years, and you know what? It's just sad.
I don't think we're going to solve the problems of South Africa by keeping the same people around the same table, making the same bad decisions with the same bad results for South Africa.
Africa's most advanced economy has some of the world's deepest socioeconomic problems, including one of the worst unemployment rates at 32%. The lingering inequality with poverty and joblessness is affecting the black majority, threatens to unseat the party that promised to end it by bringing down apartheid under the slogan for a better life for all.
We need to grow the economy. This government's management of the economy has been problematic. We need to do something about the levels of corruption, and there needs to be a recognition that if you are corrupt, you will actually be prosecuted.
After winning six successive national elections, several polls have the ANC's support at less than 50%. Ahead of this one, an unprecedented drop. It might lose its majority in parliament for the first time, although it's widely expected to hold the most seats. Under South Africa's constitution, voters elect 400 members of the National Assembly, who then elect the president by a simple majority. In all previous elections since 1994, the ANC won and lawmakers elected the party's leader as president.